Object tracking in 3D dimension was something that you could do in After Effects. Until now. This is the Auto Tracker 3D plugin from Pixel Film Studios, and on this video we're going to see how we can work with this plugin, how we can use it to place text, objects, 3D objects, what options we have, and at the end of this video you're gonna realize how this plugin changes everything in Final Cut Pro. Before we start with the tutorial, I want to say that if you want to purchase this plugin, you will find a link in the description of this video down below, and if you use the coupon code EMILIOPIXEL, you will get a discount. I'm not telling you the discount, you will see it as soon as you place the EMILIOPIXEL on the coupon code. And before we dive into Final Cut Pro, a small note here: the resolution and the frame rate of the project and the media that you're gonna use, it's best to match. So keep that in mind as well, and let's go into Final Cut Pro and see the plugin in action. We are in the Final Cut Pro interface, and after we download and install the FCPX Auto Tracker 3D plugin from Pixel Film Studios, we will find a lot of different options into the title section. We see that we have the basic text, we have stylized titles. This is a variation of basic, rock, metallic, and different already made themes that you can use for your titles. Then we have the drop zones. The drop zones, you can use them, for example, on the photos that they can float, or any video or photo that you want to float into the 3D space. We have composites. For example, we have dust, fog, particles, rain, snowfall that we can place again into a 3D space environment. We have the 3D models, and on the 3D models, we're talking about a number of 300 plus things that you can place. I'm scrolling right now so you can get an idea what this plugin can give to you. The options are limitless. For this plugin to work at its best, you need to select clips that you can track the environment. So you can choose clips with parallax effects, moving into different spaces, and you don't want to use static shots. For example, shots in a tripod, shots that they're not moving, or they're moving like that on the panel. To show you how you can use this plugin, after you have placed your footage, the first thing that you want to do is to go into the effects panel, grab the analyzer, and place it into your footage. And after that, you're gonna click to launch editor. A new window pops up. If you know the sensor width and the focal length, you place them here for best results. You will go into the camera solve settings. You're gonna make sure that your playhead is at the beginning, and you're gonna click to solve camera. Keep in mind here that the analysis process does take some time, so don't worry, the plugin is fine. It just needs a little bit of time to analyze all the scene correctly. After you finish with solving the camera, we click on export data. And then we close the window. Then we copy the solved data, and from the titles library, we select one of the 300 plus included templates, so we can place them to the timeline. Let's select the distressed 3, we place it on top of our clip, and then we select this title, we go again into the inspector panel, and we click in paste data. Don't worry here, because the title is gonna look empty until you paste the data. After we finish with that, then we go to launch editor. On the launch editor, we select the plane that we want our text or our object by simply selecting 3 points. So we can scroll to the video. Let's say we want the text to appear here as we're going, and we're gonna select this point, we're gonna select this point, and let's select one on the right as well, this point. So we have a plane ready, and we click in export data. And our object is in the 3D space. Now we select the title, and let's go and see what adjustments we can do into the object. In the spectrum on the right, first of all, to change the text, we're gonna go here where the text is, and we're gonna change the entry. For example, we can say an example. We can change the font and all the text related stuff, and then we go again into the section of the plugin, and we have the camera controls where we can apply a depth of field blur, and we can adjust the different amount that we want. Of course, the filter and the filter shape, the depth and the focus offset, and also the focus animation, if we want to have a focus animation as we move on to the scene. Then we have the transform controls, where we can change the scale, we can change the position on the X and Y axis where we want to be, and the rotation. We have also text controls that we can change the name, so we can skip the previous step, and we can have the anchor point to character, word or line, the anchor position where we want that to be, the depth and the slant. Then we see that we have the option to change the position on the X, Y and Z axis, so we can place it forward or backward, and also the rotation as well, animation and scale. We have the option to randomize the text if we want to be, you know, a little bit of out of the straight line. We can select to animate in and animate out. For example, with the animate in, you saw that in the beginning, you have an animation when it's showing the layer, and on the animate out, it's going out. If we want to animate in the beginning, we can select from the options of in sequence, in format animation, and in 3D animation. In sequence, for example, we can have it through the sequencing, and animate by character or by word, by line. Let's select character without spaces. And then for the animation to happen, we go where we want this to appear, and we select the layer to have the beginning when we want this to start. So we will have the animation in as well. We can disable this, and then we go to the style controls, where we have the option to have a glint, a little bit of more contrast, indent, we can have stroke, and then we have the light controls. The text and drop zones presets use different lighting and shadow controls from the 3D model templates. The 3D model templates use an artificial lighting setup in order to offer the best results. So here that we have a title example, we can change all the different parameters of the light, and we can add if we want an ambient light, or we can change the spot angle, the X and Y angle, the fall off, the intensity, and also we can add shadow. As you can see here, we have a shadow on the back that we can change the opacity, the softness, the fall off. Inside the shadow option that you just saw, you have an alternative method as well. And this method matches a lot if you have done the same thing in programs like Photoshop, for example. So you take the 3D layer, you duplicate it, you place it where you want the shadow to be, you turn all the lights to the zero, and then you go into the effects, you select a Gaussian blur, you can blur it a little bit, and you can create the shadow wherever you want with the 3D object as a duplicate. And if you place the 3D model on a surface that it has reflections, you can activate the reflect text, as you can see here. Now on the road, this is not something normal, so we can leave it out. I hope you found this video helpful and you learned something new today. Thank you to Pixel Film Studios. Thank you, as always, for watching. I'm Emilio, and I will see you in the next video.